We're going to start our tour of New Bloomfield, Missouri, with the man that God is using to work with us here at New Life Charlay Farms, John Kendrick. John, during your time here, how has it helped change your life?
Probably as far as the humility is concerned, it's a humbling experience that the Lord teaches you to be as far as raising cattle, bringing in new guys off the street that has nothing going for them at all, and we try to spread the word to them. That Jesus is the way to go here.
And he's done a major work in your life.
Oh, praise God on that. I had nothing going for me. It's been a learning experience every day, and I ask the Lord every day for help. I learn every day. I learn from these guys. I learn the do's and the don'ts. I learn about these cattle. Sometimes they're smarter than I am, but...
Well, you've been learning from the veterinarians, too, haven't you?
Yes, veterinarians. My golly. I didn't know nothing about veterinary work, and I could probably go to school and be one now after what I learned about these cattle.
Well, New Life Charlay Farms has got some top Charlay cattle that are up in the top 10% of the registered herd, and it's been exciting to see how God has put it together. You haul the hay, you see they're fed, and just a whole lot of things you do.
I see. I, for one example, how the Holy Spirit helped me out and during prayer, is I had three calves born in sub-zero weather, and I asked the Lord for help in this, and he intervened, and all three of them calves made it through that cold, cold, sub-zero. My golly, only by his grace that we could have got by there.
That's exciting, and I see you got a collection of feathers that you find on the property all stuck in your hat there.
Yes, sir, if I get them to stand still.
And we thank God for what he's doing all the way from the
Amen.
New Life Charlay Farms. Also, you work with the tilapia fish, don't you, in the greenhouse?
Yes, sir. I give a class a couple times a year to the public. I train these guys on taking care of greenhouse, raised bed gardening, raising tilapia fish, which is another experience, renewable energy.
Yes, it's just some of the major things that they're learning out here as the Lord is just working in the lives of these men. Well, let's go inside now and talk to Andre. He's on the radio. The Here's Help Network is located out here in New Bloomfield, Missouri. And from this location, it feeds 8 radio stations throughout Missouri into Arkansas and other places. Audrey's with me. Audrey, how you been doing?
I've been doing okay, sir.
You came to us as a homeless man.
Yes, sir, I did, yes.
Tell us about it. Were you pretty disorientated, pretty frustrated? We had a lot of problems?
Yes, I was in a bad relationship that was going to no end. They had no means to. So I just decided to come to the shelter. You know, so this one.
So now, and then you came out to New Bloomfield. You're out here at our residential training program. You're the man working with Carl and putting things on the radio. It's a country gospel radio station with a lot of ministries that are on. How is it helping you grow in the Lord by doing this?
Helping me get closer to him spiritually, and the songs are inspiring, and knowing that I'm helping somebody that might be going through the same things that I went through, or they might have a broken heart, or come from a broken family. So it's kind of easy to come in every day knowing that I'm going to help to somebody that's helping me at the same time spiritually.
Right. And if you're traveling down the road, wow, you can pick up the Potosi station. You have the Vienna station that's coming to you. 2 stations out of Marshfield, 2 out of Joplin, Harrison, Arkansas, New Bloomfield. Wow, the Lord is just sharing the gospel all right here from this location, right?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
We thank God for those that are supporting this work, because we couldn't do it without our faithful partners and donors. If it wasn't for this program, what would have happened to you?
I really couldn't say I'd probably still be on the streets, so I'd be lost. Wow. We'd know where to go.
And now you found Jesus and you got a purpose for your life.
Yes,
don't you?
I do. Yes, I do. Yes.
A purpose for one's life, serving God, worshiping God. We give God the glory, and how I thank God for what he's doing at this particular hour in the lives of so many men as a result of all of you that are praying and sharing with the New Life Evangelistic Center. You came from St. Louis. John came from St. Louis. A lot of people come from other locations, haven't they?
Yes, so they come from way out of town, like Milwaukee and Memphis and stuff like that. Yeah.
And Springfield. What a mighty God we serve.
Hello, my name is David. I've been out here about 4 years here at New Life Evangelistic Center in New Bloomfield. 4 years ago, I was taken in off the street by Larry Rice, and he's helped me very well since then. He's given me a place to live. He's given me a chance to worship and be with my brothers every day in Christ here. I've been well taken care of, always had a good place to live in. I'm treated very good here. I've learned lots of job skills. Have a chance to work every day and enjoy a good life. You can't have a better life than enjoying a life with Jesus Christ. Every day is a blessing out here. And every day is a chance to get better and right with God. Every day when you wake up, you need to think how God has blessed you every day with the help of Larry Rice and his ministry. If it wasn't for him, there'd be so many of us out on the street with nowhere to go. And I think every day that Jesus gives me a chance to call him my brother and God my father. And through Larry Rice, I'll have a chance every day to get a little bit closer with him.
I'm with a man that God has really been moving in his life. He's been drawing closer to Jesus. Tell everyone your name.
My name's Robert.
Robert, you came out of Springfield. Uh-huh. Had a pretty rough time on the streets there, didn't you? Tell me about it.
Yes, I sure did. I had a bad problem with alcohol, and I kind of blew all my relationships that I had in the world, and had no income, bad work record, ended up on the streets and didn't have anybody I could turn to, and I was broke and having problems finding a place to live, and didn't have no income to get a place to live, and I ended up sleeping wherever I could find a place to sleep, whether it was raining or anything else.
What are some of the places you can remember, some of the streets that you slept near or parks and stuff?
Oh, I've slept in Grand Beach Park in Springfield, and I've slept in up by Commercial Street in alleyways, and down by Boonville in alleyways, and wherever I can find a place.
So what has the Lord done in your life since you've come to the New Life Evangelistic Center's training program here in New Bloomfield?
Oh, it's truly given me a place to stop and reflect on where I've been and what caused me to live the way I was living in the negative lifestyle. And I've come to believe that if I put my focus on the Lord God and His Son Jesus Christ, that I can truly have faith to turn everything around and have a better life.
So you've really seen Jesus working in your life?
Oh, yes. Uh-huh.
Wow. What would have happened if this place hadn't been here for you? You'd still been out on the streets.
Yeah, there's other places you could go, but they don't focus on the inside. They just focus on the outside. And really, really change comes from the inside. Then things start getting better, and they can take you in for 90 days or 6 months, and you'll be out, and you'll be the same person you were.
We believe that if anyone be in Christ, they're a new creation. The old has passed away, the new has come. Uh-huh. And we want to see the Holy Spirit just turn you inside out, and we're seeing that happen. I think you're working on the library here.
Oh, yes. Uh-huh. Hard work.
And then we also gather together and we go through the Bible and have Bible studies and actually taking chapter by chapter in a book called Believe to build a foundation for you. Is that helping you?
Yes, sir. It's a good book.
And we just thank God for all of you that are supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. So we have a place like this out in the country where men can get away from all those temptations, right?
Yes, it is. And there's a lot of other people here that are just like I am, and they were looking for a way to change themselves. And we kind of help each other and encourage each other. And the leaders of the program, you know, are spirit-filled and. You know, they're farther along in their walk with the Lord than a lot of us are. We can always turn to them for advice and encouragement, too.
And we thank the Lord for all of you that are partnering with us. So we have a place like this. So as our first responders out on the street, and we find men that are just at the end of themselves, they've been there, done that, they're fed up with it, we have this place they can come to, we have Marshfield they can come to, and they grow in the Lord. And a large part of the team has also been working in Springfield, Missouri. They come and work in St. Louis, Missouri. It's exciting to see how the Holy Spirit is just moving in a mighty way. And then out here, they're getting ready for an energy show coming up in a few months.
I'm not exactly sure when, but it's going to be
on Memorial Day.
Okay, Memorial Day. It's right. Going to be a show about the renewable energy program right. They've got here, and people are going to be able to come in and
they can join us on Memorial Day. So, uh-huh. Folks, you're invited. So I want you to know that God is just moving in a mighty way. You can meet a lot of these men on a personal basis. We're going to go out and talk to a few.
Hi, my name is Larry, and I'm here at New Life Evangelistic. And I take care of the feed. I'm on the cow crew, and I take care of the cows and everything. And what brought me to New Life Evangel was I had a big meth problem, and I like to do drugs. And these people found me, and I found them, and I've been here for about 4.5 months now. Things are good. Things are going really, really well. I feel a big change in me, and we'll just take it one day at a time and go from there.
I just turned 43. I've been in this state for a long time. Better do some new things, you know. I still do what I do. and it continues that way.
Hi, my name's Neil Lindsay here at New Bloomfield. I take care of cattle. I do the watering for the cattle here. We put out hay for the cattle. Most of these cows are really good. I mean, they're easy to get along with. Go in, feed them in the morning. Later on, water them. They're good cows. Other than that, there's other things I do here. I take care of the barn. I take care of, as part of Missouri Renewable Energy, I take care of the cordwood home / hay. Take care of that, the rain catch system. That's my duties of renewable energy. And other than that, it's pretty easy down here. It's not really hard work. It's something I enjoy. If you enjoy it, if you like doing it, you'll enjoy it. And that's just what I do. I love cows.
How's your walk with God?
My walk with God is enjoyable too. Closer than ever. When they said new life, it was a new life.
Tell us your name.
My name is Bobby Cadwallander.
Bobby?
Robert.
Okay, we most people, they know you either as Bobby or Robert. How long have you been in our program?
Going on a year now.
And most of the time you were doing that in New Bloomfield, correct?
Correct. I did 10 months in New Bloomfield.
Okay, so what were some of the things that you were doing in New Bloomfield?
It's a cattle farm. And we cut the grass, rake it up, put it in huge bags, feed it to the cattle. Nothing goes to waste out there. We are a renewable energy type place. We'll use everything. Nothing is thrown away. We keep our wood, we keep our scraps, we keep everything. We raise tilapia fish for the sale. We sell them. And we pretty much just worked the farm and the cattle and fed the cows every day. And
how did that prepare you for some of the work that you were doing here in Springfield?
Well, it lets you clear your head, your thoughts on the farm, and gets you closer to God. Every day we read the Bible, and every Wednesday we read the Bible for an hour. And I mean, I just be honest with you, I haven't always read the Bible, and I've read close to 12 books out of the 26 that is preserved for us.
Yeah, absolutely. So there are 66 books of the Bible, and you are immersing yourself into the Word of God, and that's so wonderful. That's what New Bloomfield is all about, is that discipleship, that camaraderie, that working together as a team, and then also just really growing in your relationship with God. And so we are a renewable place. We teach people about renewable energy, and they are able to take those skills and take them on even further. So you were learning about renewable energy, right?
Well, and you can use those skills for your own. As it's a solar power, renewable energy. It would kind of goes off the grid. If you can live off the grid, you can survive. Like you don't need this power companies and all these electric bills and stuff. If you live off the grid, you totally have no bills whatsoever.
Ike, how long have you been in the program now?
About 3-4 months.
Yeah, and most of the time was actually in Springfield, but you spent some time in New Bloomfield. What was that experience like for you?
It was just as Bobby said. It was nice to clear my head a little bit. And honestly, it was a refreshing experience. Actually having a place to lay my head at night, you know, going from being homeless, you know, and, you know, that's just something that I know that it was awesome getting an opportunity with people that were, faith-based and love God and getting to, know God better is something that I strive for every day of my life. So.
Yeah, and it really prepared you for getting to the point where you can really serve others, and it's a trial, it's hard, but that space, that area where you can really take yourself away and clear your head. And then, yeah, that important point of having a place, a security, a stability of knowing where you're going to lay your head every single night, you know, and you're in a community with other people who are like-minded in the same situation, and they love the Lord and they grow with you. So that's such a wonderful thing. How have you taken a few of the skills that you learned in New Bloomfield and really applied them here in Springfield?
Well, it was a lot of about patience. About patience, like in situations here, where, you know, you get a lot of different personalities and everything like that, not being quick to anger and to understand that you can decompartmentalize and connect with God anytime that you have, you know, a time to yourself, you know, or you can. I was actually a big person with meditation and before, and I know that that's something that is really meditative when we're out on the farm and everything like that, because you're to yourself and everything like that. And that's something that helps me be in this environment. No matter how loud it gets or anything like that, you can always take a few deep breaths and collect yourself. And no matter if you know, you're faced with any adversity, anything like that.
Talking to Sylvester at this time. And Sylvester, how long have you been out here?
About 3.5 years.
Wow. And we've got some of the New Life Charlie cows out here behind us. You've been helping with that. And some of the other things you've been doing, tell us. Just saw you doing some painting over there.
Yeah, painting, mechanical work, stuff like that.
Well, that's fantastic. I remember when you came into the New Life Evangelistic Center, the Lord has sure turned you around. Looks like you got a hunger for Jesus now, don't you?
Yep, I sure do.
Tell us about that. Well, you didn't have that before, did you?
I mean, I did, but didn't really pursue it.
You seem like you're wanting more and more of the Lord right now, okay? You're getting into the book, you're getting in the Word of God. I mean, it's happening. Tell me, what's he doing inside of you?
Making a new creation.
Making a new creation. That's great. If you hadn't come to New Life, what would you be up to now?
Don't know, sir.
You don't. Well, we certainly thank God for you and what he's doing in your life. Tell me about it out here. We got these are some of the young ones, it looks like. They're about a year and a half old, aren't they?
Yes.
Right. So these are some of the young heifers. We have a young bull in there with them. We have some babies that have been born recently. It's exciting to see how God's working, learning a lot about cows, are you?
Yes.
You didn't learn all that. I said, you didn't learn that on the streets of St. Louis, did you?
New.
It's a new experience, and new experience, and God's working through you. And thank you, Sylvester, for all you do to help so many people. And we're getting ready for the energy fair, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
All right. Well, praise God for those that are helping out.
My name is Thomas Moore. I work with New Life Evangelistic Center. I've been in the program for 11 years, and pretty much go to other sites and clean off transmitter sites, and I'm head of maintenance for our main building in Overland. And God does wonderful work. I mean, every Friday we go downtown St. Louis and pass out bus tickets and food and help out the homeless as much as possible. Get them their IDs and birth certificates, and God works wonders in this world. And that's basically what we do is help out the homeless and extend God's hand out to those that can't help themselves.
Hi, I'm Glenn. I've been here at New Bloomfield for a little over a month. I was previously homeless. It was not a good place to be in, and thankfully, it's been night and day since I've been here in with New Life Evangelistic Center New Life Evangelistic Church, and it's great now just being able to learned the word, and it, like I said, it's just been night and day since I've been out on the street, and I just hope that more people can find their way to New Life Evangelistic Church and get off the streets and find out how wonderful it is to start praying again, start reading the Word of God, and it's just so much more fulfilling than where I was a little more than a couple months ago.
When folks come out to New Bloomfield, Missouri, I mentioned Memorial Day, they'll see solar power in operation, they'll see wind power, biodiesel being made, and different type of housing construction, dome homes, and there's an earth home down here. Let's check that out. Some of the men are down here working at that earth home. If you notice, it's on the other side of a hill here to stop the wind as it blows in from the north, and they've actually cut into the hill here and have been they're remodeling this whole house right now, just doing a total remodeling work here, getting it all fixed up for actually making more room for more trainees. We have quite a few houses throughout the area here that the men are staying at, but we have more and more men coming all the time. We thank God for what he's doing. How are you gentlemen doing today? Looks like you're really going at it, working hard here. That's great. So, hey, tell us what you're doing.
Leveling the floor out.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Let me ask you just a little bit. What's Jesus done in your life since you've been out here?
He's done a bunch for me.
Tell me.
Got me off the street, getting my life together, getting closer to the Lord.
Wow, that's exciting, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
So now you guys are out here in the earth home leveling the earth floor, right?
Yes, sir.
I'm making it solid out here.
Yeah.
Well, that's great. Before you came to, you came actually to New Life Evangelistic Center, 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, uh-huh. Right?
Yep.
And you're out there with the other homeless, and then I think you said, hey, I don't want to keep on going like this.
Yeah, I didn't.
Where were some of the places you were sleeping in Springfield?
The woods, out by the tracks, about anywhere I could.
Now you got a bed of your own?
Got a bed of my own, food in my belly, and
growing in Jesus?
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Yes, that's sir. The best part, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, it's exciting. It looks like they're all working hard out here. Hey, who do we have here? It's Ganesh.
Hello.
Hi, you came all the way from India, didn't you?
Yes, I did, and I'm really blessed now, and I am seeing a new path towards God, and I really feel that there are new doors which I've opened since I've become a part of the New Life Evangelistic Center.
And we thank Jesus for what he's doing in the life.
Cannot ever thank him enough, because in fact I read today that how God connects to us vertically and we connect to other people horizontally, which makes the cross. And that is what I read, and I really hope that that I work towards that path and seek salvation.
Getting the earth home all fixed up, right?
Yes. Yeah. And now working with the levels and to see that it's level, and uh-huh. So that we get a good
learning
understanding.
We are
learning a lot of things, yeah. which sometimes you only see in in a small model, but when it comes to real time, when it comes to seeing things in reality, you get a step further in learning, and you get to see that how it is.
Some of the things you're learning here, I took it to India when I was there, talking about solar cooking, that people loved it. The ladies didn't have to go out and gather sticks all day long.
Yes.
Talked about methane gas. I mean, a lot of things you could use in India.
Even the, just like solar cooking, yes. And there is also the rainwater harvesting, or yes. Using the rainwater, which otherwise would just go down the drain. And when you learn to harvest them, it gives you a new level of independence when it comes to conservation of energy. And that really helps you feel very independent, and that helps you understand the community energy needs in a better manner.
Praise God. Well, I'm going to let you get back to work here. I'm going to talk to a few more guys that are over here. This is Lucas over here. How you doing, Lucas?
Doing good. How you doing?
Well, the place looks kind of rough, but you all are building a new facility here. You've slept in a lot worse places, haven't you?
A lot worse. I thank God every day for a bed to sleep in.
Uh-huh. Some of the places that you used to sleep in before. You came out of the St. Louis area. Some of the places that you used to stay at before you came here?
Just wherever I could find park benches, on the streets, abandoned buildings. This is a blessing.
You had some pretty rough problems. How's Jesus turning your life around?
He's turning my life around He's doing wonderful things in my life.
What's he doing?
I have a bed to sleep in. I have food in my belly. I'm around great people every day that legitimately care about me. Praise He's bringing God. Me closer to my family.
Amen.
Amen.
So y'all are getting this home all fixed up. It's already kind of cool down here, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, the Lord is good, and we thank God for the things that He's doing. Over here's Corey. Corey, how you doing?
Cody.
You came out of Cody. It's Cody, right? You came out of Springfield, didn't you?
Yep.
Tell us, what was it like being homeless in Springfield?
Being homeless in Springfield, it wasn't very good because, like, you didn't know you didn't have a safe place to go to.
Yeah. But now you got a safe place.
Sure.
What's Jesus doing in your life?
Well, I'm working on that. I'm trying to get to understand what He wants with me.
So you're surrendering to Him, but you're just depending on Him to guide you and direct you day by day.
Sir.
And that's the hunger. That's the opportunity. That's the Christian fellowship. Being out here with other brothers, a lot better than being on the streets with some of the people you were out there with, right?
Yes, sir.
And what did it mean to you to come to the day center there in Springfield?
It meant a lot. You got to actually go and sleep, and, you know, you got to eat, and they helped you out a lot. You got to shower and do laundry and stuff like that.
Yes, it works in conjunction with our outreach in Springfield, Missouri, and also our first responders in St. Louis. All over Mid-America, God is moving, and I thank God for each one of you that are a big part of that. Well, at this moment here, let's drop in and say a word or two to Roger. You came out of the St. Louis area, didn't you, Roger?
Yes, I did.
All right. And how long you been out here?
6 years.
Wow. Time passes, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And you're having a chance to work with a lot of these other guys, aren't you?
Yep.
What does it mean to you when you start seeing how they're changing and get closer to Jesus?
Man, it means that they're really changing, getting closer to Jesus as I could see them, where they're changing. But if they're not getting closer to Jesus, you can tell the difference when somebody's changed and when somebody's not.
So how do you encourage them to get closer to Jesus?
I talk with them, tell them what Jesus did and everything else.
Well, if you hadn't been a part of this out here, how would your life be different right now?
A lot different.
A lot different.
I won't be here. I'll just get the reason why I come out here to keep out of trouble. Because if I hadn't come out here, I would have been in a lot of trouble.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what God put me out here to keep me out of trouble. And working where He's still working with me.
And the men are growing each day in the Lord. And I thank God for the miracles that you are also a part of. All you wonderful partners of the New Life Evangelistic Center that are donating, helping people to be set free from the cycle of homelessness. This is a holistic program enabling people to grow in Jesus. And what a blessing you are in the lives of so many that are hurting and homeless. So if you haven't shared your special gift yet, please do it with the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can give online at NLECSTL.org and know that you're making a big difference for good.